Now, children, how do we live? Elgar?
Thank you, Haywood. It's just that I get the feeling that we're all, I mean, everybody, you know, black, white, yellow, Democrat, communist, Republicans, old people, young people, whatever.
Sure, Zelvet. Only the finest thing in my shop, girl. My good, which one of y'all is next? Oh, honey, I may close this place with this child here.
We're all like a bunch of ants. See? See, the strongest drive we have as a true life force is to gain territory.
Gosh, you gorgeous. Where do you live, baby?
It's a brand new day. Brand new day.
I've never done anything. I mean, anything quite like this before. It's like I've always wanted to do because everybody wants his own home, you know? And I've never had a place of my own.
Last night I had a dream that the world was changing by leaps and bounds. It started up in the bigger cities and it spread to the smaller towns. The people began to smile at people they'd never even seen. And when Jeremiah
like Hart Crane, the poet, who's also Cancerian. See, I'm a Cancerian. And home is very important, but we never seem to make it. So, money's never been the problem.
Put our heads together and see where we go from there. We've got to fight for what we believe in. Something's in the air.
It's a brand new day.
So, shit, I bought this house. Actually, it's a tenement house. It's in this old ghetto area. I really want to do. I just want to get all the goddamn tenants out, you know, and rip it out. It's an old goddamn house, lots of molding.
Yeah, brand new day. Yeah, I wonder if you know what I'm talking about. You better check yourself. Now our heads together.
I want to rip out all the floors, all the way up to the skylight, see? And then, like, recess the floors so you have something like balconies, and then just hang this big, goddamn, modern, spectacular, psychedelic son of a bitchin' light from the ceiling. Is that beautiful?
Bonton Heights will start a trend in urban renewal, Mr. Enders. Restored landmarks will be the latest scream, I'm sure.
I just hope you're seeing Mr. Farkas's place going so well will inspire you to feel rosy about your new place.
I can't wait.
My. Shopping without stopping.
Oh,
Enid.
Mr. Farkas.
This is the street music. Isn't it marvelous?
This is Mr. Enders.
The sconces came.
He's your new neighbor.
I'm Elgar Enders. I'm your new neighbor. How are you?
He just bought a house in the next
block. Yeah, I just bought a place a block from here. Hey, your house is just great. It's just fantastic.
Well, this neighborhood's going to be very chic, very chic. Let's hope this influx of the beautiful people is the beginning of an inclination.
Hmm? Happy. What the hell is that?
What is that?
Eviction powder.
Eviction powder? What's eviction powder?
Oh, it's nothing, Mr. Enders. Just a little voodoo.
What is this we have here?
Oh, come on, Gossier. Come to me, baby. Oh, look at the white suit.
I'm Elgar Enders, the new landlord.
You know the new landlord. Yes. You're the new landlord, man.
New landlord.
New landlord, man. Yeah.
You don't shake my hand, man.
I just want to help you. D'Artagnan's gonna strike again.
Did you see that cat move out, man?
Underground hit as played by the exciting dynamic Clive Davis Band. That's right, 200 hits for just $1.75. Incredible as it sounds, while this offer lasts. Just send checker money order to Davis Hits, Box 5152, Battle Creek, Michigan. Groovy!
Who are you?
Walter G. Colby. My name's Walter G. Are you the new landlord?
Yeah.
Hey, man, give me $2.
What?
I said you are to give me $2.
What in the hell for?
Cuz, Slicky, if you let me hold $2, I'll let you take me home. If not, I'll call the pigs.
You will, huh?
Gimme, sport.
All right, all right, all right.
God, shut up now.
There's...
cigarette pops?
Does your mother know you smoke?
No. Home, landlord.
Turn around and march your buns back out that door before I shoot them out from under you.
Are you crazy? Why are you pointing that at me?
Because my horoscope told me that evil was coming to my door today. And Marge, here it is. So get moving, or else you ain't gonna have no hips to lean on. You dig?
No, lady, I own this house. I'm the new landlord.
And I'm a rented. Move it! And if you're a landlord, how come you ain't got no door keys?
No, I have door keys.
You know... you look like a rapist to me. You got funny eyes.
That's ridiculous.
If you figure on carrying out a sexual attack on me, you better learn the karate boogaloo, because we're gonna tangle ass right here in this hall.
I am the new landlord, and you are disregarding your lease by practicing whatever you're practicing here with these readings. I'll have you thrown out. So if you want to shoot, just go ahead and shoot. That'll be running an illegal business, non-payment of rent, and manslaughter.
Little thing like you, a landlord?
Yeah, let's see how much back rent you owe, all right? Is that you right there? Huh? 2 months back rent you owe me. All here in this book.
You look like you could use some food. Come on, landlord. Let's eat. That old Dubois sales. Always up in my face talking about being some college president.
College president?
He wouldn't sweep the hall out of his life depending on it. College president. Sure, some college across town. I never heard of no college selling degrees for $50. Then there's unearthly cumbersons.
Unearthly?
Yeah. They've been here about 25 years. Ain't nobody seen him but twice. How's that for being ominous?
That's impossible.
It would be if they were alive.
Alive?
Oh, I hear him. Oh, I hear him rolling around downstairs. Listen, you should have been here this morning for the Tenants Association rent strike.
Rent strike? What rent strike?
Don't worry, ain't gonna be no rent strike.
No, now wait, now, are you sure?
I don't be in a rent strike. Ain't nobody paid no rent as long as I can remember. Of course, it could be a back rent strike, but you wouldn't get none of that either. That would have to go to Mr. Lipschultz. That's the old landlord.
Nobody ever paid him any rent?
Or so. Lord knows who'll get it now. He's passed away.
He passed away?
Rat. Big as a dog. Chased him in the broom closet. Nobody ever go in the broom closet. So I think he was in there about 3 months. How do you, old face, find your way into owning these rat traps? What do? Give them to each other for bar mitzvah presents?
I need more gun control.
You want some more eggs?
Oh, no. Marge?
What?
Say, would you mind not putting that gun away?
Don't worry. You came my way so I could protect you. Though I know you'll only repay me with suffering.
Oh, God, don't say that.
Hey, Marge! I mean... Marge, have you seen some white man prowling around here? You. It was you.
It was me?
Don't deny it, degenerate.
Why?
You gave my little Walter G. money. Now he's sick on cigarettes. I found him sick down in the cellar, chain smoking. So I know some child molester gave him money.
Well, why do you let him smoke? You must know there's a possibility he could get cancer.
Fool, I am busy frying hair all day. I can't watch everything he does. Dumbbell.
You're what? You're frying hair in this building? Do you have a license for frying hair? Because I don't have a license for frying hair.
Oh, well, he ain't got no license for frying hair.
I'm
gone to your own neighborhood and do heads, Queenie.
I'm not a hairdresser.
You better believe it.
Ben, he's the new landlord.
That's right.
The new landlord.
The new landlord.
Oh, Lord, ain't this a shame?
As a matter of fact, I'm glad
the
we
landlord.
Met.
The landlord.
Your name is,
Mrs. Copey.
Right.
My husband's been ill.
Mrs. Copey.
He has this nervous condition, and he has headaches, too. The doctor said he should have his own room.
4 months back rent. 4 months! Is that possible?
Oh, anything's possible, sugar. Anyway, we took him over to the Will's Eye Hospital because he's got this twitch, but it wasn't his eyes.
What was it?
It was his nerves.
That's understandable, Mrs. Copey.
It is. Look, why don't we go down to my place so we can discuss this at length?
If you wish.
Listen, you promise me that you won't smoke anymore.
Is your I promise. Very
What's that?
Bye.
I think
Walter G., Walter G., you come back here. Hey, Duval, what's happening?
Fanny? Copey in trouble with the pigs again?
No, this ain't no pig this time, sugar. This is the new landlord. Landlord, Professor Duval.
Professor Duval, how do you do?
I swear he thinks the Lord put white people on this earth as a punishment. Cause I don't hold with no sacrilegious talk like that. Mm-hmm. Why don't you put some air conditioning in here?
Oh, you have some complaints, Mrs. Copey?
You serious?
Yeah.
I sure do. Sit.
I'll just, Now. What specific complaints do you have, Miss Copey?
Well, we need a new plastering job, a new paint job. The oven door's broke. The roof leaks. The toilet runs all day. And you're awful cute to be a landlord.
So the roof runs and toilet leaks, got that.
You didn't sweat so much, nobody take you for a landlord. You could pass for a human being.
That's not a very nice thing to say, Mrs. Copey. Because I intend to be a good landlord as long as you're here.
What you mean, as long as I'm here?
Who's that you got out there with you?
Oh, it's the new landlord. That's my husband.
Oh, now, about the rent, Mrs. Copey, are you willful?
Landlord, these arrows have been dipped in Fanny's barbecue sauce so as to make death slow
and more agonizing to its unfortunate victim.
Landlord, you have until the count of three to vacate these premises. One, two, three.
You son of a bitch, you make one more crack about my spare ribs and I'm gonna bust your head.
Oh, you should. You should.
I thought I told you about putting your drum in the living room.
Oh, mother shit!
I'm sorry, this is the only chance I got an Italian class after this, and then you're buzzed.
God. Keep talking. I can hear you. Start it with me from the top.
Just talk about my house.
Three, four.
Mother.
What house, dear? What is this house?
I'm in love with this house.
Two.
Three, four. Five, six.
Oh, don't do that, dear. Don't. Look, you're throwing me off. He's throwing me off.
I'm just trying to help you, Mother. I've invested in real estate.
Do it.
You have invested in real estate? Oscar. Oscar.
Yes.
Oscar.
Yes, Joseph.
Oscar. Listen. Darling, listen. Will you forgive me?
Yes.
Oscar, I promise you, we'll dance our brains out tomorrow at 10.
10
o'clock?
10.
Without interruption.
Practice.
I will. Ciao. Ciao, darling. Insufferable dance goddess. He thinks the sun rises and sets on rhythm. All right, dear, quickly. What in the dickens are you talking about? What investment? Pour me some of that. What is that? Brandy? God.
What's the matter?
Just then, you looked just like your father when he was a little boy.
Oh, Joyce, for Christ's sake!
You're drunk and upset. Why?
Mother, this house, this real estate, is very important to me. It's the most important thing I've ever done. I'm a Cancerian, and home is very important.
You're a Leo.
No, Mother, I'm a Cancer.
When were you born?
On the 15th of July. Son of a bitch. When was I born? Mother.
Foul mouth. You foul mouth.
No, don't do that.
All right. You have 15 minutes, and then it's my Italian class, which I'm not giving up to argue with you about dates. You see that? You see that, my darling pussycat? What you did, it's so bad.
There's an iron curtain in this house, Mother.
Will you tell me what you are talking about?
I'm talking about doing what I want to do.
Well, do it. Right out there in the guest house.
I can't do it out in the guest house. Well, I think sometimes the way you look at me when I bare my inner guts in this house, you think I'm off my rocker.
I don't think any such modern thing as that. Why don't you take up the banjo, write folk songs, something you can do in your room. Get a bath, get yourself together, and wash everywhere. Oh, your sister has invited Peter Coots for dinner tonight, and we're dressing. Your brother and his wife, what's her name? They're coming in from Westport.
Peter who?
Peter Coots. You know Peter Coots.
Oh, the Peter Coots, of course.
Oh, God, don't get smart. Get dressed, huh? And comb your hair. All right?
Yeah, I'll comb my hair.
Yeah? I just want to say, Elder, that I'm proud of you. I'm glad you're my brother and not somebody else's.
Oh, it's a great house. Wait, I want to tell you about
this. I think somebody's got to begin to integrate. I mean, I can. I just don't have the stomach for it. Think that I have a really forward-looking, devil-may-care revolutionary for my very own brother makes me feel right in the swing of things.
Of course, that's not the reason
I got
the house.
I just hope you don't get shot.
Susan, God.
I mean, have your people planned any rallies or marches anywhere, anything like that?
Bert!
Elder, would you do me a fantastic favor?
What?
Whatever you do, don't talk about spades to poor Peter.
What do you mean?
I mean, with the napalm and all that. I mean, he's very sensitive about the new left and all that. And Elder.
What?
I love him.
Elgar! Oh, my God, what are you two burning up here? What is that?
My socks caught on fire.
Your socks caught on fire? Well, put them out and get downstairs, the both of you. Peter's getting bored.
Tastes good.
God, I love a little dance somewhere.
Susan, dear, you cannot go on falling down the stairs like this.
Oh, Mother, if you could tell me a proper way to fall down the stairs, I'll try to do it next time.
Susan, you really must get a checkup.
Come on, dear,
get out. It's clearly a case of lack of coordination. Maybe it's cerebral palsy.
Could be you smoking too much.
Young man,
I will not have you talking against the tobacco industry in this house.
Have you bought into tobacco, Mr. Anders?
Mr. Coots, in some circles, you might say I am tobacco.
That's really cool, Mr. Anders. We're napalm.
Is that all?
No, we're insecticide.
Hi there, Haywood.
And deodorant. And,
Mom.
Mom.
Hey, Junior.
Susu. Dad.
Susu. Dad.
Darn, sorry we're late, gang, but the traffic.
Oh, God, gang, the traffic.
Peter, I'd like you to meet my son.
My heavens, it's good to meet you. Susu talks of no one else. That's all she talks about all day. Elger, Elger, Elger.
William Jr.
William Jr.
Peter.
No. That's Elgar. I'm William Jr.
This is William Jr.
Why don't we all go into dinner?
Oh, yes.
William Jr.
Come along, Doris. Sorry, Dad.
Thank you, son. To you.
Thank you, Dad.
Dad.
Hmm?
I know I'm not supposed to say this, but William Jr. has a surprise for you.
Surprise?
Surprise, Dad.
What surprise, dear?
William Jr. has been promoted to head the New York office.
Yes, Dad. I'm heading the New York office.
Well, William Jr., it's no more than I expected of you. Elgar? Did you hear that?
I'm not deaf, Dad.
Elgar, answer your father. Did you or did you not hear?
Yeah, I heard him.
What are you running up the pole these days, Elgar?
Elgar's bought some real estate, haven't you, Elgar?
Susan.
Where's this real estate, Elgar?
It's in the Park Slope area, William Jr.
It's 2 miles south of the Dodd Sears townhouse on Concord Street.
Susan, take the clip out of your hair.
Park Slope. 2 miles south. Park Slope.
Park Slope.
Good God. Elgar, are you aware that, that's a colored neighborhood.
Colored neighborhood.
Oh, yes, I'm 3 doors from Mom's chitlin and rib joint.
Oh, Elgar.
Elgar, we will not discuss the revolting aspects of your business venture at this table, if you don't mind, huh?
Hey, well, what's it all about, folks?
Well, Peter,
No, Peter, actually, you might as well hear now, since you're most likely going to marry my sister. If she hasn't told you already.
Tell me what?
Elgar, don't you dare. He's about to say something.
No, Mother, we can't keep it a secret all our lives now. You want to hear the truth, don't you, Peter?
Yes.
No, because it has something to do with you and Susan.
But what are you talking about?
Peter, actually, our whole family, Mom, Susu, Dad, William Jr., and Grandfather here, we are all octoroons.
What an ugly thing to say.
An ugly thing.
It's an ugly thing.
Yes, and Haywood and Edith here are poor, dark relations.
Elgar, would you please explain your conduct at this table tonight?
Yes, Johnny, come on, apologize.
He makes napalm and deodorant.
Insecticide.
You lazy, no-good liberal.
Shall I serve the fish, Mr.
What? Oh, yes, bring in the fish, Haywood, please. Let me tell you something, Mr. Lincoln. If you march into this house with an armful of pickaninnies from this business venture of yours, the best you're going to be able to expect from me will be a swift kick in the ass.
Mr. Anders, you forgot to finish your soup.
I'm just too upset, Edith. Edith, bring in some of that wonderful trout of yours, please. I think that'll help everything.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Lord, Mr. Elgar, you sure love Edith's cold potato soup. You want some more, sir?
That's the last straw.
That's all right, folks. There's plenty more soup in the kitchen if anybody wants any.
Elgar, get out of this room.
I'm leaving.
Go.
Do you know what NAACP means?
No, Elgar. What does it mean?
It means niggers ain't always colored people.
What does he mean by that?
He called us niggers.
Us?
Heywood. Knock it off.
Rita, I just want to talk to you. No, I don't. I just want to... Rita, I want to talk... Rita!
Sally, the thing that amazes me the most is that my parents, they don't seem to understand that they are totally, totally anti-Christian.
Please, now, Elga, I'm sorry. I just don't have the time to talk to you now.
It's not as if I come
I've
around with my problems.
I've already told you I have to make festoons for the worthy causes ball.
Nah, come on. I just want to come in for a few minutes.
Let me come in for a few minutes is all.
Who's that?
He's helping me with the festoons.
Oh. Yeah, well, till I see you again, yeah, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, Happy Halloween, and screw you two.
Hey, you know that peace symbol thing you got hanging around your neck? Why don't you shove it up your ass? Let me love you. Let me
Hi.
I'm
Elgar Anders.
My name's Lainey.
Can you dance? Are you allowed to dance?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
What's fantastic?
You being here is just fantastic. Are you with Vista? Is this some sort of a new program you're involved in, huh?
Vista, right.
Volunteers in Service to America.
Volunteers, huh?
Yeah.
You think I'm white, don't you?
Oh, that... That's... Well, how was I supposed to know?
If it's that important, you should have asked me.
No, it's not that important.
Well, okay. Let's just keep dancing. My mother's Irish, my father's black, and they got divorced when I was 16 years old. And the court said I should spend the winters with my father when I was going to school. And in the summer, I lived with my mother. So in the summer, I was white, and in the winter, I was black.
God, what did that do to you?
I got very wise.
So why do you work there?
What do you mean, why do I work there?
It's a bar.
Well, I like it. And,
And what?
And?
No, no, come on. And what?
And nothing.
So if I walk up to you and I say, I recognize you, then,
Then what?
We recognize. Recognize something that we've always known. Well, I guess that doesn't make too much sense, does it?
How old are you?
29.
You're 29 years old and you still live at home?
It's a big house.
No house is that big. Well, come on, let's go.
Where?
To my place.
Sure it's all right?
It's all right, Elgar, but tomorrow you have to go home. Come on, Elgar, I have a class at 1:00.
How old are you?
24. 24? 25. 25. I'm 26 years old.
I believed you when you said you were 24.
You did, huh?
Yeah. Come on, please! All right, if you don't want your bell fixed, fine. Right? All right. Forget it. I should be getting the plans back from the building department pretty soon. So, as soon as everybody can find a new place to live, then I can start with most of the heavy work.
Uh-huh.
Marge?
What?
How am I gonna get everybody out of here?
Honey, I wouldn't sit on a hot stove till it happens.
Now in here, I'm going to rip all this area out here and see straight through up to the skylight.
Yeah.
In that area, I'll hang a big chandelier.
Right.
And here, I'm going to put in a patio right. You know, lots of used brick and maybe some tubs of flowers along the walkway here. And then, here in this corner, I thought it'd be really wild if it had some kind of a, you know, a fantastic sculpture or something, you know?
That'd be very nice.
Or maybe a bird bath.
Bird bath.
Guess what?
What?
They're having a rent party for me tonight. Can you come?
I can't. I'll be dancing tonight. Oh, God, I'm late for the dentist. I really gotta go.
Why do you have to go to the dentist?
Oh, I got this wicked tooth back here.
I've been really fortunate. I've only had one cavity in my whole life.
Oh.
That makes a big difference. If you use silver, it could ride. Hey, can I give you a ride?
Oh, no need to. His office is just a couple blocks from here. Is your car?
Yeah. Can I call you tomorrow?
Okay. Bye-bye.
Hey! What the hell are you doing on the toilet?
Hey!
Ujumbo, meaning welcome. Provided, of course, you have the necessary requisites. $2.
Professor!
Thank you.
How you doing?
Monsieur Landlord, $5.
$5? You aren't real, Professor.
Not qualifying as a spook or hallucination, I assure you, sir. I'm a bit more real than you are.
Dance 1 minute. Here he is. Our guest of honor. Our wonderful and new landlord.
Hi.
Now listen, you don't bother him and he won't bother you. Now I'll get you a drink.
Children, how do we live? Elgar?
Black.
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 Black, baby.
Black. Baby, black is a whole new thing.
And you are going to have to reckon with it.
Is it a fad, though? See, that's the thing.
Man, that is not
the thing.
It's like you got a mole.
Dig? You got a mole right here.
And you'd do anything
to get rid of this mole.
Because everybody that doesn't have moles
got you to believe like it's real ugly.
So you'd do anything?
I mean, you'd hide your face.
Anything. Walk in backwards. Anything. You'd do everything. I mean,
anything. Then one day.
One day.
One day.
Moles are in.
Moles are in.
People are getting out their eyebrow pencils, marking them on, and you got one naturally right in the middle of your forehead. You're gonna know what pride is for the first time, baby.
For the first time!
You whitey screaming about miscegenation. And you done watered down every race you ever hated.
You got any mouthwash?
It's in the bathroom. Back there.
Right back there?
Uh-huh.
Where's Copy?
He's in jail.
How come he's in jail?
Huh?
How come Copy's in jail?
Oh, he had another demonstration today. Seem like they're putting everybody in jail nowadays. I said it seems like everybody's going to jail nowadays, especially Copy.
When did it happen?
This morning. I don't know, it all just seems so strange to me. I mean, I look at Copy sometimes and I wonder, how did we get ourselves into this? Well, I was Miss Sepia in 1957.
What's that?
Well, that's like Miss America or Miss New York, except in color. Here's my trophy over there.
What, this?
Uh-huh. Francine Marie Johnson, Miss Sepia, 1957. My mother had it made into a lamp for me for Christmas. I liked it better when it was a cup. But anyway, as I was saying,
It sure has been hard on me since Kopi turned black.
Turned black?
Yeah. He was Sioux Indian for 2 years. And little Walter G. He gets so confused. He doesn't know what to think. You know, I thought about going to Chicago. Maybe California. Going to the movies or go on TV or something. I'm sure tired of doing heads. Do you think I look good enough to be on TV?
I think you look fantastic.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't know it by Kopi. He thinks I should be blacker.
That's ridiculous.
Why is that ridiculous?
Because you're beautiful.
It's just a red light. Oh. What's the matter?
Oh, wait a second. Oh, God, my head's killing me. You feel anything?
Well, you haven't got a fever.
What you got there?
Cedrin.
You got a headache too?
Duggan, this doesn't mean anything. Because I love Kobe.
Don't understand your sudden interest in those kind of people, dear. I mean, we're all liberals, but open hybridization.
I'm their landlord till they get relocated. That's all, Mother.
Well, I don't understand.
Red ball.
Oh.
I think there's something that you should know, Mother.
What's that, dear?
I think I love a girl who's a Negro.
Elgar, let's go for a little drive. I want to talk to you. Daddy?
Yes?
We're going for a drive. Something's come up. Elgar, a lot of these people, not all, mind you, there's good black people as well as good white people. I've always taught you that. But some, mind you, live to set traps for rich white women.
I'm not a rich white woman, Mara.
I know that, dear. I didn't mean that. You know I didn't mean that. It's just, Elgar, didn't we all go together to see Guess Who's Coming to Dinner?
Yeah.
It's just, Elgar, you have to realize all Negroes are not like that.
Well, you sound like a segregationist. I think you have a castration complex that leads you to say things
you
like that.
You have a castration complex. I can't have a castration complex. It isn't physically possible
for me to
have
a castration complex. Oh, let's face it, Mother.
A castration
complex is one of the crosses a liberated female must bear.
Oh, you think I'm liberated, dear?
Joyce, you are a liberated, aggressive, butch American broad. Doesn't mean I don't love you.
What does it mean, dear?
It means I'm gonna do what I want with my damn life.
So, you're going to marry a negress?
You'll be happy to hear she's very light.
Son, do me a favor, make sure.
Oh, Mother, I don't care. Now, don't you understand? Why don't you come down to my house and help me plan what I'm going to do with it?
Me? Your castrated mother? What could I possibly do to help?
Just help me plan it. You can pick out the drapes, wallpaper, stuff like that. Huh? Huh?
You only have to ask, dear. That's all you've ever had to do. And don't worry about that girl, dear. If she's putting you on, she's most likely only Jewish. Heywood, I shouldn't be long.
Let's go. Come on. Go on.
If you're from the police, they got him already.
I beg your pardon? I'm Mrs. Anders.
Oh. The landlord's wife?
Oh, thank you very much. I'm his mother.
Oh.
I didn't get your name.
Marge. Just call me Marge.
Marge?
What's your name, dear?
Same as my son's. Enders.
What's your first name?
Joyce.
Yeah. What you got there, Joyce?
Oh, I was just browsing through House Beautiful, and I came across this material for drapes, and I thought I'd drop over and measure the windows and have some made up for Elgar for a housewarming gift, but...
Isn't that thoughtful? I sew.
You do?
Mm-hmm. I made all the designs for Ruby Randall's fashion show at the Rock of Ages.
You did?
Mm-hmm. Listen, darling, drink your wine before the ice cubes melt. From the looks of this apartment, obviously the water comes in second hand.
Oh, that's very good.
Travis, this will tear your head off.
Why does it foam like that? Is that carbonated?
Oh, it's just ruthless. It's ruthless. Listen, would you like to have a little lunch? I got some ham hocks, I got some greens.
I never eat lunch. It's my own diet. Never.
Honey, you better sit down and have some lunch. How are your white folks going to defend yourself if you don't eat?
What is that?
Pot liquor.
Pot
liquor. Juice from the greens.
Oh.
It's lead in your pencil.
Lead in my pencil? Oh, yeah. Ho, ho.
No. Joyce, you can get at those hocks a little better if you take your gloves off.
Oh, God, my glove. Actually, I've taken up re-embodiment.
Re-embodiment? What's that?
We live again.
Don't count on it.
Oh, yes. Oh, I have something to tell you. I did something very naughty this morning.
You did? What'd you do?
Guess.
You dirtied on the floor.
Oh, no! No!
Well, now, give me two more guesses.
Hell no!
That was...
Oh, it's funny.
What?
I forgot what I did this morning. Isn't that funny?
It's a wonder you remember where you are, honey. You on your second jug. Let me pour you another little nip here.
I wasn't important anyway.
No.
So, as I was saying, you know, I was very popular when I was young. And all the young men were so attractive. Oh. Oh, God. And my husband.
That was...
I can't remember which one I married.
Last night, I...
Elgar, what's bothering you?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
I just,
Elgar, say it.
Shit.
Now, what is the matter?
I forgot my lucky number again.
18. 18.
18.
And your note is E flat.
Ooh.
Hey, more.
When do I hit this note?
here anytime you like. It's yours. Listen, now, don't you worry about the baby. I'll make the drapes and I'll get the material. Won't charge nothing like the decorator.
God, I don't know how to thank you. Here.
Right.
Here, take this charger plate, honey. Get what you need. Just take a swatch of that material and get what you want.
Mm.
I'm going home. God, wherever that is.
Listen, let me wrap up a couple of these ham hocks for you.
No. I just, give me my bag.
You're all right, man. Seem to enjoy them so much. Here, take three. I got plenty more.
Stay cool, Mark.
Mm-hmm. Can you make it, doll?
Stay cool. Why is my mouth so dry? Oh.
Hi, Ernest.
How are you?
Hi. Got a lot of reservations?
Yeah, we're going to have a great day. Good.
Yeah.
Morning, honey. Leave perfume, lipstick. Anything like that around, man. You know, it's like nobody sees it. I don't understand it. Chicks just go blind.
Try Miss Thing. She had a date last night.
Miss Thing, you seen my perfume?
I think we ought to check her pocketbook, man.
No, I don't think you better check my pocketbook.
Still, get this pocketbook to me.
Get hostile.
Listen, you raggedy-ass black bitch. Don't you mess with me.
Let me tell you something, you high yellow heifer. You have to get a lot blacker and a lot badder to stand there and call me a black bitch.
Get something straightened out, honey.
Because you got yourself one of them little blue-eyed wonders don't mean a fucking thing to me.
What's the matter? Huh?
Nothing. Nothing else.
Nothing? What,
I quit my job.
You quit your job?
That's right.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know what I'm gonna do, Elgar. I just don't know, so leave me alone.
Hey, what happened? Something happened? What's the matter? You gonna tell me what's wrong?
raise $150,000 for Laura's thing next month. We've got the cooperation of St. Andrews and that whole bunch.
Joyce, darling, Lily's been moved to Mercy Hospital. It looks very bad. It's a matter of time.
Oh, poor Lily. But I don't see what that has to do with it. She's not on the committee.
I know, but if Lily passes away, dear, the funeral will be an absolute must.
Oh,
Joyce, isn't that Elgar coming in there?
Oh, thank God. Elgar? Elgar? Elgar, what is this costume? Did you come all the way here to embarrass me? Who is that? Is that Bunny Oliver behind those glasses?
No, Mother, this is Lainey. I told you about Lainey.
You did? What did you tell me about her?
Remember I told you I thought I was in love with her?
Elgar, come and meet Mr. and Mrs. Dory and their daughter. They came all the way from Virginia. Excuse me, dear. It was so nice to meet you.
Mother, will you screw Mr. and Mrs. Dory and their daughter and screw Virginia?
Mother, stop. Your committee is waving the cocktail flag. I think things are falling apart at the bar.
Oh, my God.
Elgar, I'm so glad you came.
Yeah, hi, sister. How are you? This is Lainey. It's my sister Susan.
Divine.
Hello.
Elgar, Peter's here. He's marvelous, and he's dying to see you. Well, where the hell is he?
This is Elgar.
Hey, William Jr.
We're looking for Oscar.
Have you seen Oscar?
I don't know who you're talking
about.
One
who carries the flag.
Well, must
be late. I don't know an Oscar.
Never mind, Elgar. Come on.
Well, listen, if you
wait
see
a second,
Oscar.
Doris, I want you to...
Elgar.
Oh, yeah, scotch and soda on the rocks.
I'll just say
you want something?
Yeah. Elgar, it's Peter.
Peter
Coons. Peter Bojangles Coons.
Oh, do a little dance for us, Peter. And you're Shirley Temple, right?
Yeah, I'm Shirley Temple. Elgar, Peter and I are engaged.
Oh, congratulations. Peter.
Susan! Stop that exhibition.
We're going out for a smoke.
Enjoy yourself. Dad? Oh, Dad?
Huh?
Listen, I want you to meet Lainey. This is my father.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Isn't that a great costume he's got on?
Great.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yours too. Yeah. Well, before you get too drunk, I think I want to have a talk with you. If you'll excuse us, dear, huh?
Certainly.
Come, we'll find a place where there's less noise.
Wait, Dad. Wait a second.
It's all right.
No, come on. We can't. I want to talk.
I took a drive past that house of yours in that dreadful slump, and upon investigating your rent records, if you can call them records, I discovered that you get no rents from those hoodlums.
Yeah, Dad, I think you're misunderstanding.
And there's one doublet that goes under the dubious title of the Cumbersons, who hasn't paid you any rent in over a year.
Yeah, Dad, they're an elderly couple. They have no funds, no relations to take care
Son,
of.
Son, I think you haven't got the guts to ask them for the rent.
They're too old and sick to even come out of their own apartment, Dad.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Listen to me, are you sure you're not just afraid? I mean, that in case you did ask them for some of their back rent, maybe a few months' worth, that they might not riot and run that roach trap down.
All right, Dad. Let's see how heartless you can really be. You're so tough, right? If you listen to that old man's poor, pathetic voice and demand money from him,
we're going to have a civilized conversation about the issues of this disgusting business venture of yours. There's got to be law and order. Now sit down.
No, I'm not going to sit down, General, whatever the hell your name is with your fruit salad and everything. Marge? Listen, will you try and get Mr. Cumberson to the phone, please?
What?
Oh, no, no.
Oh, they did?
Oh, holy shit. Yeah, I'll be right over. Son.
Hey, did the joint burn down? Young man? What's your trouble?
Marge! What happened to the...
Well, I think the Cumbersons got a new lease on life or something. They're gone.
The radiators, where are the radiators?
You didn't want those old radiators in the house.
Right,
do a junk man and get you plenty of radiators.
Okay.
You don't need them.
Oh, beautiful. They took the stove. That's why not? Why not take the stove? Place looks like a damn tomb.
I just came out to Cannes again. I've been fighting the man out here in the street since I was 7 years old. I came out the house, and the first thing I smelled was some paint. And the only
place... he's fixing his place.
He's fixing his place. He is in a place where there's some poor people sitting out here in the street.
Anybody?
I got something else. It's little, but well, it's kind of special. I hope you like it.
Oh, gee, hon, I can't get over everything. I really can't.
It's like I told you. A little paint and some curtains and, well, a few $1,000.
And you got yourself a real nice place. Hey, you didn't even open up my gift.
It's an egg.
That's right. Could
you tell me where I might find Mr. Enders?
Oh, the landlord lives in the basement, lady.
Hi, Mother. How are you? Come on in.
Elgar, I want this entire poverty program that you're on dropped.
Mother.
No. I want you out of here within the week. Within the week. No.
Mother, you will not walk into my house and order me about like that now.
And another thing, you tell that Marge upstairs I want my charger plate back.
What charger
plate?
Don't
you charger plate me. That's my drapery material. She's out for the entire plantation on this.
Oh, Mother, don't call this a plantation
now.
You
dumb cluck.
What?
You really aren't concerned, are you, that you walked boldly into the Spinal Meningitis Summer Festival ball at which I begged you. I begged you to come in the costume of a dead American hero.
Well, Susu came dressed as Shirley Temple.
Susu did not come as Shirley Temple.
Oh,
Susu,
the hell,
she came as little Eva.
All right, I'm not gonna argue with you. Not gonna argue with you.
Look at you. Why don't you cut your hair, Elgar? You look like a floozy.
Mother, in about 2 seconds, I'm gonna really lose my temper and I'm gonna throw your ass out of here. Okay, what's the matter with you now? What is it?
Nothing. Don't pay any attention. Go right on with what you were saying.
Joyce, if your heart doesn't attack you in a few minutes, I will.
Attack me? What do you mean? Do you mean sexually? You pervert, I'm your mother!
Okay, that's it. Go on. Out! Get out! Get the hell out of here.
What have they done to you?
What have they done to me? I'll tell you what they have done to me, Mother. For one thing, as I'm sure you've already noticed, I have run away from home. I'm 29 years old, and I have run away from home. Now, doesn't that strike you as being just a little sick? You.
Elgar Winthrop Julius Enders, you no longer have a mother.
Thanks.
Do you think the lady could excuse us for a minute, landlord?
What for? What do you want?
Excedrin headache number one.
Lay your kinky woolly head on your mammy's breast.
Toby? Toby, what you doing?
I'm trying to fill out this application so I can go downtown and get some money for the white landlord.
Toby, I gotta talk to you.
Mm-hmm. What? Hey, what's the matter?
What's the matter, babe? Kobe, I'm pregnant.
You what?
I'm pregnant.
I told you, don't come to me like that. Now, what is it we can do? What is it can we do about it? Now, you are pregnant and you're going to have a baby in how many months? How many months, baby? How many months pregnant are you?
Kobe, it ain't your baby.
What do you mean it's not my baby?
It just ain't your baby, honey.
You mean to tell me that somebody else has been sleeping in my bed while I'm gone?
Big goddamn.
What you want to do that for?
Who was it? Fanny?
Oh, Linda!
I said, who was it? Oh, what is it?
Don't tell me!
Come on. Why did you want
to do that? It's not!
Whose baby is it? Whose baby is it? Whose baby is it?
Kobe. Kobe. Ah! Kobe, don't. Oh, Mama, Mama! Ah! Oh, help! Help somebody!
Faith!
Kobe, 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 no! Kobe, 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 no! Kobe, no! Come here! Kobe? Kobe? Kobe?
Wait!
Hey, mister, wait a minute. You don't need to go in. Okay. Just wait a minute.
Wait!
Mister, wait. Just
wait. Oh! Wait!
My mama. All but one. Had blue eyes. Hmm?
Yes, I know, Kobe.
Uncle Harry had good hair. Christ has never known the horror of nappy hair in America.
Yes, Kobe, yes.
It isn't enough. I have just been a Jew. I have been a black Jew. Don't let them transplant my heart till I'm dead.
No, Kobe, no, I won't. I won't let them.
Hey, boy.
Crummiest thing you've ever done on a date.
Crummiest thing?
The crummiest.
I lost my girlfriend. I mean...
You lost your girlfriend.
We went to Disneyland and we went on, you know, Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. And we came... You know that part where it goes bumpy, 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 bump? And she bumped right out of the car. So I went on again. I picked her up, though. You know, it was really crummy.
Bastion number three.
I'm just gonna stay around here. I think that's, you know, what I should do. Be with her. Make sure everything, you know, everything's okay.
This is why you haven't called me?
Yeah. Don't look at me like that, okay? Because,
Why?
Why what?
Why have you done all of this?
Because I'm a bastard, Elliot!
I love you, Elka.
Can I help you, sir?
Oh, I have some lunch money for a little boy, Walter G. Copey.
In the basement.
Step down into Gettonbury. Killer! Moving forward. Lunge punch. Shit! Here! Stop! Stepping back. Shit! Here! Stop! Shit! Here! Shit!
Mr. Copey, your wife and new son are just fine.
Copey? Copey? Oh, Copey. I don't want to see it.
Well, you don't have to say much.
Well, I don't want to see it. Elga, I love Copey. I can't take the baby home to him. I won't do that to him. It's not fair, Elga.
I think you ought to get some rest. Okay? And then I'll be back in a little bit.
Would you take the baby?
I can't. What am I gonna do with a baby?
Do you think it would be all right if I put it up for adoption?
I guess so.
That's what I'm gonna do. I want one thing, though.
What's that?
I want him adopted as white.
Okay. Why?
'Cause I want him to grow up casual. Like his daddy.
Come in.
Mr. Enders. I want to pay you your rent. All rent is to be paid to Mr. and Mrs. Copey from now on. Really?
That's right.
It reminds me of the man who put a black family in to work a store. Fool the neighbors. I gave this house to Mrs. Copey because I don't want it. Do you understand? I don't need it. Did she need another baby too, Mr. Enders? Oh, God, you're an evil son of a bitch. However, evil as I am, I'll put this rent under the Copey's door. No school today, Professor Dubois. Yes. There's school today, Mr. Enders. However, I won't invite you to come in order to class. I dare you. Could you find yourself a seat, please, Mr. Enders? Mr. Enders, over there. We've all had our breakfast today, so you'll be comparatively safe. Now, Laura Ann, define relative knowledge.
The principle that knowledge is related, relative to the limited nature of the mind and conditions of knowing, and therefore not true to the nature of independent reality.
Jean, what is a triangle?
A figure formed by three lines intersecting by twos and three points and so forming three angles.
All right. Ernest, law and order.
White, police, soldiers, gun. Mace, obeying the white establishment.
Naturally. How do we live? Elga?
I am black and I am beautiful.
James?
I am black and I am beautiful.
Malcolm?
I am black and I am beautiful.
Louise?
I am black and I am beautiful.
Mr. Enders? See, ladies and gentlemen, some people can't learn what we learn.
Cause they can't stop what men do. And that's why, Lord, I call on you. They don't even know. They don't know how to sin. But these are troubled times that we're living in. Listen, when bombs fall, children will cry. And yes, Lord, some will die. And that's why I got to say, Lord, Lord, Lord. Bless the children. God bless the children. Teach us how to love like never before. And may we never, never, never study war no more. Talk to the hearts of the men who lead us. And make them understand right now, Lord, it's the children who need us.
Ready!
I know.
Hold it!
I know. God bless the children. So many times.
Lady! Come on down! I can hear you!
That trouble.
Will you shut your mouth?
watch your ass. Get out of here.
I'm not saying that this phrase is wrong. But I'm wondering right now, how come it's got to last so long? You see a newborn baby in some proud mother's arms. And then you think of all the countries that now have the bomb. And you just got to say,
no.
Come on!
Children, mm-hmm. God bless the children.
Say it a little bit loud.